once I get it down, I'm going to move my knee up. Mm-hmm. So that'll stop him from doing it back in. Now, when he brings it back in, I have my knee over. I'm already kind of able to straighten his arm out. Okay,
sir.
But what happens a lot, we get a dismount, they're going to overhook my arm. So they're going to get on the shape like this, and they're going to tie up my arm, okay? Once they tie up this arm, the next thing they're going to do is look to trap the leg. So put your foot even closer to mine, like just trap it. Yes. Now once he has me trapped, my arm and my leg, he's going to take his right hand, put it on my hip, and just turn and roll me.
I'm going to wind up here.
Okay? So that's a basic hip escape from a mount, okay? So the thing is this, look. As soon as he traps my arm like this, I know what's coming next. I know what's coming. I know he's going to trap my leg. He has to, because the only kind of escape from here. So as soon as my arm is trapped, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my head on the mat, and I'm going to swivel this here. And I'm going to bring my head up. So now when he bumps or pushes, there's nowhere. Because for any time for a sweep to work, the hips have to connect. Can't push my hips, there's no sleep. So if I'm here, okay, even when we're here, look, his hips, watch when he turns me, his hips are gonna push into my hips, right? Push, push, push. That's what's gonna make me go. So as soon as he comes here, look, I'm gonna bring this leg up, I'm gonna bring here, and I'm gonna bring my head up in here like a tripod. So now when he bumps, if he can't make contact with his hips on my hips, he can't roll me. Hey, there's no role for me. Well, what is it just bring you up? Okay? We're gonna, anytime we get under this arm, we're gonna come here, I'm gonna bring my elbow in like this. It'll be really tough for him to move around from here. Very, very tough. He won't be able to get his arm down. If you keep your arm straight like this, he's gonna be stuck here. We're gonna put our hand on a mat over his head, we're gonna come around and we're gonna circle. Start defending his arm. What we're going to do is we're going to bring our foot, bring it over, and we're going to lock. That's what you do. Okay? So now this is like a normal kind of escape, a normal kind of defense that guys do. They're going to lock their arms down like this. So what we're going to do is we're not going to go for this arm. They're always going to expect you to go for the closer arm. We're going to go for the far arm. So we're going to grab his elbow here, and we're going to pull his elbow in like this. That's going to release the other arm. when he pulls it tight, look, if he does this kind of mistake, defense, we're going to come deep, and we're going to sit back with him. That's going to straighten his arm up, and it's going to free up this other arm. It's going to work for you every single time. Sometimes, we can put so much pressure that we can get a submission with that arm. Okay? So when he's holding it tight, look, depends on the grip. If he does a different grip, we're going to do something different. It all depends on his grip. He was doing this kind of elbow-to-elbow grip, something like this. We're going to straighten this out the best we can. Yeah. It's going to start to hurt his shoulder. Okay? And then we can get this arm, or he can wind up getting underneath here, and we can look for submissions this way. Doesn't matter. If he has a different type of grip, we're going to do something different. Sometimes they'll go under the knee like this, and they'll do like a rear naked choke defense. Something like this. This happens a lot. So, in here, you're not going to have as much success straightening this out. So you're always going to just try to get under the arm like this and put it in your armpit like this and bring it up. And then you're going to cross your hip across your chest. It's going to be very hard. And which way am I going to fall? I'm going to fall towards his head. Because again, we're working on rotator cuff. So if he's holding tight and I go this way, he's very strong. If I go this way, he's very strong. If I go this way, he's not so strong because you're working on this shoulder rotator cuff. It's tough. It's a tough angle. So one more time. Okay. So I get stuck. I'm in the mouth. Catches an arm. So first thing I do is I'm gonna come here and try to pile the face. Okay? And then I'm gonna come down, scoop up, and bring this out over. From here it's really tough for him to move. If he moves, I follow him to my chest. I'm just going to stay with him. Okay? Now, if this arm is in my way, see how he's using his arm? Watch. I'm going to take this foot, I'm going to swivel it, and I'm going to catch his arm. And then I'm going to turn. Okay? I'm going to wind up here. finds his head. When we start to come up, look, this leg comes over, he starts to come up, and then I'm going to come this way. He's going to start coming up, and then we're going to bring the leg through, and we'll start coming out the back. It's a little bit tricky. I'm just showing you different options. So, for the drill, if you do this much, as soon as he hooks, we turn. Come down and we try to hold it. Come through, sit him up. If we can get around his arm, good. Sometimes he'll have their arm on our knee because they don't want us to come forward. We got to take the other foot. Three, bring the foot in, use the hand, whatever you got to get to here, straighten and come out. Your foot should be by his head, like this. Now you're going to come over. A really tricky one is once you get here, you let this out and you come this way. So, whenever we let the foot out and we come this way, even he's going to still be holding his arms, but he's going to feel like he can turn into me and sit up. Let me show you. I'm going to show you the whole thing. Watch how it looks. He overhooks me. I swivel and tripod and come up and I come down. Okay, so now he reaches out, grabs my leg, I swivel, come around, I come up here. I get to here, right? So watch. I'm here. I'm going to come through, and my foot's going to come to here, right? Now, I'm going to go here. I can't break his arms. He's got swatches. He's got super strong arms. Can't break his arms. I come here. I can't even straighten this. Too strong. Can't do anything, right? So this foot is just going to come here like this. Now, what do you think happens from here? He rolls up on me. The leg hits straight. I'm going to come here. So now, I'm still going for this arm, but he's not letting me. Watch. I take the back arm and I bring it in. It's a triangle, a side triangle. Let me show you that one more time. Let me do it again so we're not going to watch. So watch on both sides. Actually, let's do this here. This is going to give you a nice flow of a bunch of different techniques. So we're here. He traps. Swivel, tripod, scooch. Okay? Now I got a nice grip on him. I look for this and I spin back. Boom, I come here. So once I'm here, I look, he's not going to give me the arm, right? I'm going to bring my foot up, and I'm going to bring it through like this. And I'm going to switch. So now I'm right here. This outside foot comes under his head like this. Mm-hmm. And now I'm here. I'm still going for the arm. If he gives me the arm, I'm still going to take it. He's going to feel like he can come up on top of me, because my foot's not up on his trick.
Right.
The foot's not over his head.
Right.
So when he rolls on top of me, I just take the leg straight, and I take this triangle right here. So now I'm going for the sidewalk, but he locks his hands together. So we get the back arm, and we just bring it in like that, and we're going to get submission. If this is
Thank you.